Hello everyone, my name is JMLisondra and today I'm going to teach you how to paint this wonderful landscape painting. So my subject will be the zebra. So I'll put the landscape and the zebra will be my subject, okay, the center. Okay, and please don't forget to subscribe if you haven't subscribed it, and hit the bell button if you want to receive some future notifications on my new videos and tutorials. Okay, you can see all the materials needed on the screen. You can see there the five limited colors, the brushes that we're gonna need, and all the things that we're gonna need to paint this painting. Okay, so I'm going to start now. And I have here the sketch. I already have the sketch, and I'm gonna do now, what I will do now is to add the underpainting. So, yeah. So, okay, so you have now the sketch, and let's add the underpainting. I'll try something like greenish. I'm gonna use the palette knife to mix. Yeah, we can spray it like that. I'll put a little bit of colors, like maybe orange. I want the background to be much more like a dry autumn background. So I have here the orange. There. I want a little bit of umber. Raw umber and a bit of white. Just make it abstract, everyone. You can mix blue with the umber. Can make it a bit darker. Can add a bit of greenish just in the top, yeah, like that. So this is the second part, everyone, is the underpainting. So I will add this underpainting first. Okay. So if you are painting with me, just follow what I'm doing, okay? There. You can cover some parts, everyone. It's fine. Actually, I'll just cover some parts also. You may cover the first, the grayest color. or the light raw umber, like that. There. Okay. And here again, we can add the raw umber. Let's have to add the raw umber, everyone. Or you may add a little bit of orange also, red and then yellow. Especially on the ground, okay? So a lot of dust on the bottom. Okay, there you go. I think it's a little bit dry, especially in the background. I have to make the background slowly dark, okay? You can also put a bit of lighter purple. Maybe I'll put a little bit of depth. So maybe I'll put the depth a little bit here, this part. So purple, blue and the red and in white. Kind of that a bit of depth. There. I'll just make it a bit of abstract, everyone. I don't want to make it so much blended, good, something like that. Let's make the background a bit of abstract. A lot of textures you can see there, okay? Okay, here you go. We can also add here, like that. Blue, and the red, and the white. Add a bit of like that, everyone. And then you can try some raw umber, like that texture, everyone. There, okay. Can blend a little bit like that, just blend it. There. And then we can add some trees, everyone, because this will be like a forest. Or maybe I will put something like an opening here. It will be a great idea to add some white part here, opening. So like maybe there's really an opening there. So it will be a great idea. So we just have to add the light blue color here for the sky, okay? You can add a bit of white. Yeah, yeah. There. And then we can make this a little bit of lighter color, purple, to create a bit of atmosphere and depth. Just blend it slowly, bits by bits, everyone. And we can see a bit of difference. Okay. Yeah, something like that. And then let's try to add forest here in the background. Yeah, let's do a little bit slowly those trees, okay? So I will be using now a new brush, a new bristle flat brush, everyone. It is the medium size, number 9. So I will be using this red flat brush now. I should clean first the bristle, okay? You should always clean first the bristle, everyone, because I just add a little bit of water and then clean it. That okay? So let's start adding some trees there, some something like that. So yellow and the blue, and then white. There, I like this texture, everyone. It's small. Nothing in here. Let's blend a little bit. My light source will be from the right side here. So, like that. And I want to make this part on the bottom a little bit misty, everyone, like that. Yeah, just make the forest a little bit misty so that we can see a bit of beautiful atmosphere, okay? As you can see, a little bit of atmosphere, and then we can now start adding some darker leaves, blue and umber, and then some white. Just stopping technique, everyone. Okay, so yeah, just stopping technique. I want to make a little bit of background darker, everyone, because I want to create a very good contrast between the there. Okay, here you go. Another blue and the red. Blue and the umber, sorry. And then some white. Can also put it here. You can put more umber, everyone. Make it look more brownish. Okay, there you go. I have to blend more, especially in the top part. You can also add some lighter purple, everyone, or something like a misty part of the bottom, something like that. like that. I do not need to make it so good, everyone, so blended. I just have to make it look fine, okay? I'm using the dry brush. Okay, now I'm going to add one tree here, just one big tree. I'll be using the small flat brush. The smallest flat brush I have, the nylon flat brush. I have the raw umber. Let's add here. There. There, maybe a little bit bigger. There, like that. Then you can add some branches. There, and then on the distance, everyone, let's add some also tree trunk there, but it will be lighter because it's a bit misty. I just add a little bit of white there, it's too light also. There, so you can see that it's a forest. You can see that this forest is very misty. There, you do not need to make everything very light. Okay, so I'm going to add some brownish leaves there, or maybe something like that, some dark, but I will just add very few leaves, everyone. Very few. I'm going to use the red, the yellow, and then some more umber, maybe a bit of blue. Yeah, the leaves look like brownish, but I think I need to add more blue on the umber to make dark. You can also put a little bit of orange, yellow, and then red. You can now see those textures there. I'll just do like that. I will not allow any lights there for now. I'll just put some branches. Just a umber run using the very small flat brush. Okay, there you go. So this part, everyone, I just lit it like that because there's no light here. Maybe I'll just put a little bit of greenish or brownish there that you can see. You can see a little bit. You can see a little bit, something like that. But I will use a very not so bright green, okay? With a little bit of white. It's an off green, everyone. That'll be 3 years. And just like that. So that the part there will not be so obvious. Something like that. So you can see some sort of greenish, maybe even here. You can add a bit of highlights, but not so much. There. Okay, so we have now something like that. It's dark. Yeah, it's dark, I know. But I just like to put it like that, okay? So, yeah, I'll just let that 3D run, that 3D1 to look dark. Because on the left side, I'm gonna make it bright, okay? I'm gonna make it a little bit bright that it hit by the light coming from the right side. Top right side, okay? So, I think that will be the light source. But I want to make it dark and misty, something like that. I want to remain it like that. So here, let's add a bit of dark. Okay, so I think I'm gonna put some umber. Pro umber and then blue. Yeah, let's select that. Because I did not need to make it so good at all. Okay. And then I will add a little bit of orange or brownish color here, right there. Yeah, okay. Okay, so I'm going to add a bit of lips here, everyone. I want the lips to be really obvious. Okay, so I'm going to try to put a bit of lights here. So just a plain light blue color. Oh no, I mean light green. Okay. Hitting by the lights. There. A bit lighter. So I do not need to put everything there, just show that some parts hit by the light, so there. I will not put everything there, just this part. But this part, I want it to be bright, everyone. I like to. I'm gonna mix it with a little bit of light green also. I'm gonna mix it with a light green also. And then we can put the light orange. Kind of like that. There. Okay, now we can put this light, this yellow, okay? Just do like that, everyone, make it dots. There you can see now, just lights, okay? And even on the other part, everyone, just put a bit of, so there's some leaves. There, and I'm going to try to put, tree trunk. So I'm going to add the light color first, white and umber. Okay. Yeah, I like those few lights, everyone, but it looks really good. And now, let's add some okay. Okay, there you go. And then we can put now some yellow, just yellow everyone, one by one. I'll just do it one by one everyone using the very small flat brush. I know it's made of very small round brush. Okay, so just slowly everyone, one by one, we can add some highlights, especially in this part. I want this part to have a very good highlights. I'll just put a light green everyone on the side. I think something that I need to put there, so that the entire view will be complete. Some light green, and you can do like this. There, something like that. So that we can still see a little bit of plants on the edge. There, something like that. Okay, at least it's not so much. At least you can see things there. Okay, so I'm going to polish first the background before I'm gonna make the zebra good. Okay, so I want the background to be reddish, something like that, orange. So I'm gonna use this umber, but I need some yellow, more yellow. Some yellow and then red. Yeah, I'll go first some light greens, especially here, some yellowish grasses. And then here, I'll try to That'd be 12. Raw umber. Just a bit of umber, everyone. Maybe here also. To create some darks. There. Okay. I'm going to add some orange. Just do like that, everyone. Just drag it down to create the grass-like effect. So here, so there, and even here, I'll try to add a bit of light. There. You can also do like that, everyone, tapping technique. You can create as much as different types of grasses here. maybe I'll make it lighter here. Okay, so I'm going to add now the details of the zebra. So let's add first the white. I will be using this big brush, this smallest flat brush I have. We have here the white. Let's try to add first the highlights. There. Okay. Yeah, something like that, everyone. You can adjust. You can also try to adjust. I will be adjusting also some parts. There, okay. So I will adjust also even the lightings, because I think that the light is coming from the top right, everyone. Okay, and then a little bit of lights here. So I'm doing first the okay, so you can see now the lights, everyone. It's clear. And even the ear part. Just a little bit. There, this the proportion now it's becoming better and it's good. Now let's add some darks. I will be using the bigger flat brush, the medium size flat brush I have here. And now I'm gonna mix for a little bit grayish, everyone. So maybe it's just raw umber with a little bit of blue and then red. It will become gray because I'm not using any black, so yeah. So I just had to create gray parts. There. Some parts are just dirt, everyone. Some dirt. Some dirty part of the tanky. Okay, now I'm going to add a bit of white to make it lighter. You can lean a little bit. There. And also here. Okay. And then on the face part also, everyone, protect the tear. There, and then I will be using now the smallest, the smaller flat brush, this one, so that I can make some parts with to refine some parts. So here, this side that it's a bit darker. Maybe here, some cars, some curly parts. Okay. I'm gonna use a darker part here, but I can use directly the umber. Also here. Okay. And then I'm gonna use some raw umber and in white, maybe a little bit of yellow. Yeah, I just make this part a little bit lighter, everyone. There will be a bouncing light coming from the bottom part. Okay. And the light should be a little bit yellowish. And even here, we can put there. Okay. Yeah, that's really great and beautiful. And even here, everyone, we can add a bit of light. There. Yeah, as you can see, the lights now, it's being established, and I like it. I like the lights now, everyone, and yeah, I've been like that. It's great. Just have to retouch a bit more. It's already here. I just removed those outlines, everyone, those hard outlines. That's so good. And then you can add a bit more darks. Some textures, a bit more textures. There. And then I'll just use this umber to darken this part here. And then also the his feet, everyone, should be darker. And then you can put the tail using the raw umber. Okay, so it's now clear and good. I'll make this darker. And then I'm gonna use the smaller brush, everyone, the zero liner brush. And then let's add some details. Sorry, the nose part. I hope that I'm not blocking. There. We have there the blue and the red to make some dark purples. Then some white. I'm going to add a bit of white. There. Maybe some raw umber, but it's fine. Raw umber and white. Okay. So, sorry about that, everyone. The noise. I hope that you cannot hear this noise there. Okay. Yeah. Can go like that a little bit. Can add a bit of brown. There. Okay. So I'm going to add some white. And here one on the ear part. I'm gonna make it a little bit darker with the umber. Okay, now it's time to add the stripes. So yeah, I will use first a dark color. So since I have no black, I'll be using the red and the blue to have a dark purple. There, okay. I'll be using a dark purple, everyone. So you have a hair also on the top here. Okay, so I'm going to put now the stripes. Okay, so you just have to follow the patterns. Those patterns, everyone, might be a little bit complicated. I put a little bit of umber so that this will make it dark. Let's try the umber with a little bit of white. There. Okay, that's good. It doesn't have to be perfect, everyone, like the reference, but you have to copy everything there. Okay, so also here. Okay, so yeah, you can see now those beautiful stripes. Yeah, and then you can continue doing more by using the darker color. Okay, so here I'm gonna put some umber with the purple and the red. If you made mistakes on the details, everyone, it will be fine. It's fine. Don't worry about that. There. Okay. It's a bit challenging, but I love it. Okay. There. Okay, that's very fine. Very fine and good. Okay. Yeah. So yeah, we have to do this part slowly, slowly, everyone. Yeah, this part is very time consuming because it takes a lot of time to finish, especially the small details. Each zebra, everyone, they have also different colors or different stripes. It's like their identity also. So slowly we are getting those beautiful details. So let's continue. So just use, everyone, the smallest flat brush or smallest round brush you have. It's very important that you need to use small. Because we have to do it a little carefully. There. Okay. Yeah, it's a bit curves. So if I'm not speaking everyone, that means I'm concentrating. So I just follow what I'm doing, okay? Just have to try. Okay. You need to have a lot more patience on this part, everyone, because you know doing these details, it's really okay, so we can now see the zebra. If you're asking me where I get my reference, everyone, it is from Pixabay, okay? It's free and it's royalty free, okay? So we have nothing to worry about that. There are also stripes that are not so visible, so it's good, everyone. I like it. It's so simple and it looks pretty good. Looks like a zebra. Yeah, it's looking at us. Okay, so I'm going to add, I'm going to make the tail darker. Yeah, I think that will be enough for the zebra, everyone. I think that it looks good, and I think it will not be so complicated if you're gonna try that. So I'll let you see everything, and I will try to retouch. I'm going to add some more details, and then I will be done. I think it's just pretty simple, but it looks so good. I like the simplicity of this, and also the contrast of the zebra to the background. So good, you can really see the zebra clearly there, and it's pointing on it. Okay, so I'll just try to retouch and I'll be finished. I'll try to add a little bit light here, the umber and the white. There. I'll add a little bit of purple here on the left side. And then I can add a lighter brown. Yeah. Maybe you can put some lights there also. Red and then yellow and then white. Yeah, at least there's a bit of light there. Okay, so I will be using the palette knife to add some So you really have to do like that because I have no space here. There, you can see the light. Okay, so I'll be using the brush, okay, this bristle flat brush. We can add a bit of few lights, especially in the top of the tree. Like that. And then we can do here. We can break those there, and then I can add here like that some solid yellow. Sorry about that, Bryce. There, and then I can also put some darks. Okay, so yeah, I think that will be all, everyone. Oh wait, and I have to also to improve on this part here. Okay. So I think that will be all, everyone. It's almost 2 hours and I am enjoying the whole process of this painting and I love it. I love the result. It looks so good. It looks realistic. I like the ground. I like the zebra and everything here. So I hope that you also like this one and you are also learning how to paint this zebra in the forest.
Okay, everyone. So I want to say thank you for watching this video today and I hope you get something out of this. And my only advice is to keep on practicing, keep on painting. The more you do it, the more you know how to use your brush, the more you will know how to mix the colors. That's why I'm using limited colors in my palette, because I want you to learn how to mix and get the desired colors you want. So please hit like and some comments, subscribe for more videos in the future. Okay, once again, thank you. Have a nice day and God bless you all. All the glory and honor and praises always belongs to the Lord.